In this quick tutorial, you'll learn the easiest way to run sentiment analysis in Microsoft Excel. Imagine you've got a long list of customer feedback. Wouldn't it be great to instantly see if it's positive, negative, and what people are talking about? Now, with the power of AI in Excel, you can. Hi, I'm Kevin, and let's dive in. Here I am in Microsoft Excel with a list of customer feedback about the Kevin Cookie Company. Now, I'd like to think it's all positive because we make the best cookies around, but you never really know until you look. And with this much feedback, that can be overwhelming. That's where sentiment analysis comes in. What are people saying? Do they love our cookies? Do they have complaints? Knowing this helps improve operations and attract even more happy customers. Now, in the past, you'd have to read every comment one by one. Today, let's see how AI can help. Quick note before we start, this feature requires Microsoft 365 with Copilot. Also, make sure your workbook is saved in the cloud. Now, on the Home tab in the top right-hand corner, let's click on the Copilot icon. This opens up the Copilot pane over on the right-hand side. And to begin, let's ask for a high-level summary of all of this feedback. Right here in the prompt box, I'll type in my prompt, and then right down below, let's send that. Here's the high-level summary that Copilot generated. Right here at the top, it automatically pulls out the overall sentiment. It looks like it's mostly positive. Then it breaks it down by all the different positive themes. And if we scroll down a little bit more, here we can also see all the different negative themes. Down below, we even see a summary table with all the different themes or categories of feedback, and over on the right-hand side, we can see an example. Instead of reading through every single comment in the worksheet, I can see what's working well and what needs improvement right over here. My manager specifically asked me to pull out all the feedback related to pricing. Now, we could scroll through here and try to find comments related to that, or let's try asking Copilot. Right over here in the prompt field, I'll enter in, show me all the feedback related to pricing, and then let's send that. And here it is. Copilot found one piece of feedback that mentions pricing. I don't have to spend any extra time searching for examples. As a bonus, we can even ask Copilot to generate a word cloud of all this feedback. Over on the right-hand side, I'll type in make a word cloud of this feedback using Python. This taps into Python for even more advanced analysis. Let's send that. And there it is. Copilot automatically writes the Python code, runs it, and gives me a visual word cloud. Let's download it to see a larger version. And there it is. The bigger the word, the more often it appears in the feedback. So far, we've been analyzing this data through Copilot Chat. Now, let's switch gears and use the new Copilot function to analyze sentiment directly in the cells. In the top right-hand corner, let's close the chat pane. And over in this column right here, I want to see the sentiment for each piece of feedback from our customers. To do that, we're going to use the new Copilot function. To let Excel know that we're entering a function, let's start by entering in an equal sign. Then we'll type in the name of the function, which is Copilot. Then let's open the parentheses. And here we now need to feed in the arguments. And we need to start by entering in a prompt. So here, I'll open my quotes, and here I'll type in my prompt, give me the sentiment. Then I'll close my quotes and enter in a comma. Now we have to enter in the second argument, and here it says that it wants the context. In this case, that's the customer feedback column. So over here, let's highlight all of the customer feedback, and then over here, let's close the parentheses. So we have our prompt, we have the context, then let's press enter. How cool is that? We get this sentiment returned right in the cell. And let's spot check a few just to make sure that they're accurate. The cookies from Kevin Cookie Company are absolutely delicious. Well, that sounds positive, and here it says positive. I found the packaging a bit damaged when my order arrived. Well, that sounds like a complaint or negative, and here it says negative. Here, we've confirmed that it's working properly. The text here works fine, but maybe you're more of a visual person. We could even customize the prompt. I'll click back into this cell, and here we see the original prompt that says, give me the sentiment. Now, instead, I want Copilot to return the sentiment as emojis instead of text. So over here, I'll highlight the original prompt, and let's put in a revised prompt. Give me the sentiment as a smiley face, just a neutral face, or a mad face. Now, let's press enter. And look at all those faces. Pretty cool. And here's a neat trick. Once you have the sentiment in its own column, we can use Excel's built-in filters to drill down even further. I'll click on the column header right here. Then let's go up to the data tab, and over here, let's click on filter. Now we can click on this toggle, and let's say that I just want to see where we can improve our service. So here I'll uncheck all, and then let's click on the mad face. So click on okay, and right here we get a quick summary where we could spot check areas for improvement. To turn off the filter, I'll click on this again, and now we see all of the different feedback. This makes it really easy to slice the data however you need. Now that we've pulled out the sentiment, let's take it one step further. Instead of just knowing whether a review is positive, neutral, or negative, I also want to understand the theme of the feedback. As an example, here, this first one has to do with the product, the second one, the packaging, the third one, delivery time, and also customer service. Let's click into cell C9, and we're going to use the Copilot function once again. Let's start by entering in equal, and then type in the function name Copilot. Then let's open the parentheses, and first off, we need to enter in the prompt. Here, I'll open my quotes and enter in my prompt. Give me the feedback theme slash category. Then I'll close the quote, and let's insert a comma. Now we need to enter in the second argument of this function, or the context. Well, I wanted to come up with a category or a theme for all of this feedback, so let's highlight all of this feedback. That's all we need to enter in, so let's close the parentheses and then hit enter. And just like that, each piece of customer feedback is now grouped into clear topics. Here, this first one was talking about the product, and here we see product quality. The second one was packaging, here we see packaging. The third one contained two different areas, delivery and also customer service, and here it successfully chooses those two different categories. This worked great. This makes it so much easier to see patterns across large sets of feedback. Let's now try changing one of these feedback entries. Down at the bottom, we have a positive piece of feedback. I would definitely recommend Kevin Cookie Company. So let's replace that with some negative feedback. Right up above, I'll remove this comment, and instead, let's enter in, "The cookies were so hard, I thought I'd accidentally ordered Jawbreakers. Ouch." And just to be clear, no one actually sent this to me in an email this morning at 8:52 a.m. Now, watch what happens when I press enter. The sentiment updates automatically. Here we have a mad face, and if we look over at the theme, now it refers to product quality. Let's wrap up by looking at how we can summarize this data. For example, maybe you want to know how many comments are positive, neutral, or negative. One of the easiest ways to do that is with a pivot table. First off, click anywhere into your data. Then go up to the top tabs and click on insert, and right over here, let's insert a pivot table. This opens up a prompt, and here I see the range. This looks good. Down below, let's click on OK. This drops us into a brand new pivot table. If you've never used pivot tables before, don't worry. I've linked a separate video in the description that'll get you up to speed quickly. They are so powerful and make it much easier to analyze data. I want to know how many comments are positive, neutral, and negative. Over on the right-hand side, you'll notice that we have something called pivot table fields. Each one aligns to one of the columns in our data. Right over here, I'll take the sentiment field and let's drag it down into rows. Now, within the pivot table, I see all the different types of sentiment. We have happy, neutral, and mad. But I want to see a count. So let's take sentiment again, and then let's drag it down into the values category. And just like that, I get a count of each sentiment. 9 were happy, 3 neutral, and 3 were mad. But let's say instead of looking at this sentiment count, I'd actually like to see a count of the feedback theme. Over here, I could drag sentiment out of rows, and let's take feedback theme and drag that down in place. Now, I could see all the different categories of feedback and how often they popped up in the feedback. It looks like most of the comments related to product quality. And to make this even more visual, I can insert a chart. Right up on top, let's click on the Insert tab. Then, right in the center, we have a category for charts. Let's click on the one titled Pivot Chart. Then, over on the left-hand side, I can choose the type of chart. I think a pie chart would work well for this, so I'll select this, and down below, let's click on OK. And look at that. Excel instantly creates a nice visual showing the feedback themes by count. Here too, I could also see that product quality came up most often in the feedback. And there you go. Anyone can run sentiment analysis in just seconds. The sentiment here, it's positive. The only time it's negative is when the cookie jar is empty.